see the good in him, even in days where, you know, it can be blurry for me. Thank you for just speaking wisdom into me and just letting me see that life isn't always easy, but when you find a good person, you have to hold on to that. So thank you for just encouraging me on this journey at all times. And then to my family, my mom, my dad, my brothers, Uncle Steven, Asikana, little Keon, Uncle Kade, Uncle Steven, thank you so much for coming along with us on this journey. You guys made my in-laws feel at home in Nigeria. And thank you for just trusting me and trusting that I made the right decision with him, because I know I did. So just thank you for, again, my brothers, for respecting my now husband. Thank you for just, you know, supporting us. You guys know the ins and outs of everything. Thank you for praying for me. Thank you for just, again, encouraging me and being with me throughout this entire time. And before I get to my husband, I just want to say a moment of silence for my mother-in-law. I never got to meet Mama, but she loved me regardless. And even though she's not here with us, I know she's smiling, I know she's resting, and I know she's happy, and she would have loved to be here. And I'm just grateful that despite, you know, her not being here, I'm just grateful that we had her blessing before proceeding with this day. So just, you know, say a little prayer for her. I know my brothers, my siblings all told you I was strong, but they didn't tell you I was a crybaby, so. Anyways, now to my husband. Yolo Joe Taban, my love. I want to say thank you for standing by me. Thank you for being patient with me and the kindness you've shown me. You came into my life and it didn't take time for me to realize that you, what a blessing you were to me. You showed me a selfless type of love I never knew existed in humans. The way you love me truly humbles me. Thank you for being a man of virtue, a man who has reverence for God. Thank you for your calm spirit and for being my peace. Thank you for sharpening me in all aspects of life and challenging me to be the best version of myself. As we stand here, not just before our family, our friends, but also before God, and as we go into this covenant of marriage with God as the head of our family, I vow to continuously honor and respect you. I vow to be your first, I vow to put you first in my life, only second to God. I vow to continuously pray for you and be your helper in building our home, ensuring that God is the center of it all. I vow to continuously care for you in the best way that I can. And we may not know what the future holds, but one thing we know for sure is that God holds our future. And because of that, I know we'll be fine. And I love you. And again, thank you, each and every one of you guys, for being here with us.